the Miami Dolphins did not stay away from the wide receivers and have added now former Cowboy Cedric Wilson to the roster. Wilson isn't flashy and was outshined by Amari Cooper and the other Cowboy receivers, but he is a good consistent receiver who should see plenty of opportunity in Mike McDaniel's offense. The signing isn't breaking the bank for the Dolphins like Christian Kirk did with the Jaguars, but it could mean that at least one or two current receivers could be gone or that a couple of others may not be back. Mac Hollins and Preston Williams are free agents officially on Wednesday, and so far there has been no indication that either will be back. The same can be said for free agency Albert Wilson. On the roster, Allen Hurns could be a guy Miami moves off to make room for the new Wilson. Wilson is a young up-and-coming receiver who still has development ahead of him. He has played all of his first 3 years with the Cowboys after being a sixth-round pick in 2018. He has played in 16 games each of the last two seasons. In 3 years he has started 4 games and has 67 receptions on 97 targets for 837 yards and 8 touchdowns. 6 of those coming in the 2021 season. The Dolphins needed to add wide receiver help after last year's mismanagement of the unit. Miami has been linked by rumor and speculation to more than a few top free agent wide receivers, as well as potentially targeting the position in round for the second year in a row, in April's draft. The breakdown of the contract as well as the guaranteed money in the deal has not been released. Emmanuel Ogbah is going to make a lot more money in the next few years, and the Miami Dolphins are keeping a good talent. As the start of free agency was set to begin earlier yesterday, the Miami Dolphins managed to get Emmanuel Ogbah under contract, and as is typically the case, social media immediately divided on the subject of his contract. Ogbah will get a $64 million 4-year deal with $36 million guaranteed over the life of the deal. On the surface, it is an okay contract, and some fans are saying that the Dolphins overpaid for the defensive end. In reality, however, it's a 2-year contract. Ogbah should be able to continue his level of play the next few years, but if in the event he does not, the Dolphins have an out after the second year if they want to. According to Over the Cap, Ogbah's deal is team-friendly. In year 1, 2022, Ogbah will only count $7.6 million in cap space. This will allow Miami to work with the roster this year without having to worry about cap economics immediately. In 2023, that cap number jumps to $18.6 million, and in 2024 that number jumps to $19 million. The first 2 seasons will see a guarantee of $19 million, but in year 3, 2024, there is no guaranteed money. The Dolphins would still have dead money if they released or trade him, but the dead money drops to only $6.5 million in 2024 and then to $3.25 million in 2025. While Ogbah will get plenty of money from this deal, the Dolphins have worked in a way to get out of the contract if they need to. The best part is that in no single season will Ogbah go over the $20 million franchise tag amount that is currently set. This may not look like a great contract on the surface, but Ogbah is hardly being overpaid. His consistency and leadership on defense needs to be accounted for when we tend to just look at his statistics. Miami was smart to lock Ogbah down, and this contract isn't that bad, not bad at all.